Sorry?
Yes, it's recording.
Hi, my name is Mireille Vandenheuvel, and this is Winston. Winston is a Tennessee Walker that is going into five. This is the starting the third season, so we had him for 2 years. And he, except for a saddle on, he didn't have anything. So I'm believing that he needs to learn a little dressage. I took him to Florida for the winter, where I go, and somebody helped me because what I find with him is that he's not responsive very easily. So when I was trying from riding to do a leg yielding, it's like, he's very strong on what. So I had a person taller than I and more knowledgeable than I help me, and then I will do the same thing. I will mount him, and then we will do. We did some on the ground just to trying to, you know, bend
him. Step over,
And he, at the end of the 2 months, once a week, class, but practicing, he was able to turn on the forehand and turn on the hind.
Very nice.
And that's the extent of it.
And as far as arch ride?
The ride, he does trail ride.
No, I mean arch ride. I
just find out looking in the internet and totally look at work that was to do with dressage, and art to ride came up, and I said, oh my gosh, this is what I need. Things from the ground, not from the top.
Yeah.
And so I immediately look instructors, I find their name.
Perfect.
I called the same day. This was like 2 weeks ago. So
that's amazing.
Except for watching the videos and saying, yes, yes, yes.
So you didn't want to try because you're like, I don't want to screw him up, he's too young.
Well, I did not. I believe in groundwork for everything I do. And so because I was always the dressage starting from the top of the horse, I figured we're missing something here. And so when I heard the presentation of Art to Ride, and they were saying we need to supple the horse, I was like, you're talking my language.
Yes.
And so I said, I need to learn everything.
Awesome.
And so this is my first real
hands-on. Got it, perfect.
I never had anything. My background, I used to teach at the college, so what I'm saying is I believe in instruction very much, but the right one. And I don't want to start him collecting or doing things, especially with the gait.
That's the end result.
That they need to extend their, when they do the running walk, they extend their neck. And so the other person in the side that I wanted to class from, she said, I can't deal with gator horses. I don't understand.
Yeah, I know. That's smart of her. Very smart.
So I just decided when I spoke to ask you, and you said that you were willing to work with him, and so, and my other, she's a Rocky. And so both is, the idea is I don't want to force them into a false collection. And he is also very strong on the front. When he, except when
he's hammering his front leg.
Yes.
And that's going to break him down over time.
And so, on the other hand, when he wants to rock and he feels good and all the horses are going, now he's collected and, he's more up.
He's using his hind end.
Exactly. Yeah. This one does not invert. The other one, you will see, I'll talk to you, does invert. But
I
can
kind of tell because his back is pretty, low still.
Right.
Yeah, that's
so
awesome.
Before I screw everything with him, and he's so young, and he has no knowledge or anything, I thought, what a good experience to start the right way.
So we've had email back and forth. I don't know. I'm hoping they can hear me, but you can certainly hear me. So the idea with Arch Ride is really centuries old, at least and thousands of years if you go back to Xenophon. It's the original classical foundation training, which for the horse, you're sitting in the weakest part of the horse's back. They're big, strong animals for what they do for themselves, but they're made for flight and walking. That's really all they were made, evolved to do. And so what we're trying to do is create a horse that is sustainably carrying a rider and moving in a way that naturally creates... naturally creates a bridge that becomes a big leaf spring, inverted in leaf spring. So that way, when they're moving over the ground, the leaf spring is absorbing all of the concussion throughout the whole body. It's a complete dynamic energy system that goes from the hind end. So for us to get brake inertia, all we have to do is lean forward because we're bipedal. They're quadrupedal, so they can't really lean forward to go forward. This engine has to push them out of inertia. So if you're not engaging this, what they do is they drag themselves out of inertia, which automatically throws them like this, with their back arched. So the spinous processes are made to be open and bent all the way around. When you're inverted, it's unnatural. They only do it when they're running from prey. It's very rare. So they're not made to run around working inverted. So what ends up happening, especially in the area under the saddle, is that the spinous processes go this way. They change angle all the way through to the wither, up over the wither, and they start to rub together. Most horses end up with it in here. This is pretty weak too, unless you've built up the loin. And how he will change over the next year from a really pretty nice conformation is that this will flatten. He won't have a ridge where his spine is. The muscle will build here, 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 here. And then the withers are going to go like this and up. Because these are not tied. The shoulder blade is not tied anything. So when you get the horse to engage up into the belly, they activate this belly muscle. You'll actually see him engage a line right here. And it actually pushes each stride up through the side of the horse straight to the wither. So he will gain 2 inches in height from his hind end. He might not grow 2 inches. He will flex his hocks even when he's standing out in the field. And this will become more and more uphill as he gains more top line. Because the withers is loose and you're activating all the muscles to support the sling around the chest, and the core is where everything is picking up this hind leg, bringing it forward, as far forward under the rider and his own center of gravity as possible. So all you're doing, it looks a little awkward if you've seen the videos. You're asking him initially to get as close to the ground with his nose as he can. So what happens to his back? All of these spinous processes open up as far as they can. That's not enough. It's all about inertia and gravity. So they have to stretch all these spinous processes and then be moving fast enough that they break the inertia and create the cycle of energy that starts from the inside hind up to the withers, over the neck, down through a very loose pole into light as weight of rein contact bit back to your hands, which is just basically asking for more bend this way, more bend this way, or hold so they don't curve their neck too much when they're going sideways. And then this is pushing up into that outside thing. And that is the cycle of energy that creates the top line. It takes 2 years to take a horse unfit. Doesn't matter whether they've been riding 20 miles inverted, because these muscles have never been activated. So they might have muscle and muscle, but there's nothing in the bridge under the saddle. So we like to do it without a saddle at first, because you want to be watching as he develops muscle. This will flicker. Mm-hmm. And the further up here it flickers, the more you're building the top line. So he'll start developing here. These are the muscles that really matter, because they're the ones that lighten him, give him the strength to keep the bend, the longitudinal bend, while he's going faster and faster. And then sideways, and then canter. So he's using his whole body for every stride. So since you haven't done this at all with him, I already tried to do a few things while you were getting wet.
Okay.
And he's really good now. He knows to step sideways. So it's basically a leg yield around you.
Okay.
So it's always forward first and over. So I might ask him for his first step to go sideways. Over. That's good. See, he stepped away from me. Now if he stepped into me, he's got, she taught him something. I don't have anything. Walk on. Good boy. So the outside rein is more important. This is just to say, stay toward me. And I'm doing this backwards. Hold on. Good boy. Good boy. The way to do this is to, this is mimicking your leg. You have to invert the whip and your contact. This is the hardest thing to learn. Everything else is easy. Once you get this, and the beauty of it is you're practicing for 2 years. You're going to get a masterful training, and then you can take it with anyone. Walk on. So that's all. Ask him over, away from me, which he already knows. And it's, you know, at the beginning, the contact is going to be irregular, because he's irregular. And if I try to worry about the contact, we'll both be frustrated in 10 minutes. All I'm asking him to do is stay away from me, walk in a circle, and the movement of the inside line hind to the outside rein, good, will actually engage his back and he will have to drop his hip. So as soon as he does that, I have to give. Mm-hmm. Now, if he's not getting it, or if he's coming into me, then you lift the inside hand, but only briefly. You never want to hold anything in the horse, because they just lean in. They don't learn anything. So you give, you see if he takes it, you try again, and don't wait too long to do it in between. So that was pretty good. A horse that's really never done this. Again, I'm asking him to hang on to him first away from me. Good. Good. Walk on. Good boy. Good boy. And then I'm just going to do this until he stretches. And at home, the first time he does it with you, stop. Put him away. Then retreat, praise him. That will be the strongest reward you could give him. He wants to please so bad. He's just not sure when is the whip going to touch him. So he can't relax until that happens. So I'm not fit enough to do this for 45 minutes like Will does. And I don't really expect him to stretch today. One of the things you can do, where the horse is just not getting it, have a treat and just lift the bit into hit the corner of his mouth until he gives you the right response. And he's so stoic, he probably won't do anything. But that's just a trick. The movement is what forces him over his back. This hind leg going up into the wither and stepping under. And you just keep asking. Walk him. Because as soon as you ask for more, he's going to pace. You don't want him to pace right now. It's very hard for them, the gated horse, to be round and pace. They really have to have their head up out of the way to do it. So at home, you do this. And you think walk is not doing anything. When you're walking that fast and you weigh 900 pounds, you're doing a lot. Especially stepping under, activated muscles he's never used before. I can already see this is filled in just from that little bit. So first thing is to, where's the whip going to go? No, the opposite. That's riding. Yeah. And then you're going to use this finger. So that one's got to be free to grab the rein in here. And then let it actually drop down like that. So the whip is here. The rein is, you could put it through a little whatever feels more comfortable, like if you ride here, you might want to drop it down, but you'll find the spot.
I worry about this.
Yeah, so you want to put it through your let go of this. Then you have all this freedom to activate the whip. And the rein, the inside rein is like the least important thing. But it does have a role. You don't just throw it away. The main thing is if he actually decides to put his head down, you have to be ready to go like that and reward him. And then as soon as he'll pick up his head, usually they can do that for about two strides, really engaged, and then they stop or they lift their head. So then you got to shorten the reins almost immediately. You can just stop and get reorganized, it's fine. Reward him or quit initially.
Don't push
if you don't have to.
Okay.
You actually want to use the whip to get him away from you.
Good boy.
Now he's stepping right up into that. Beautiful. So look. And the higher you can go with your left hand, the better. Because, especially initially, because then you have a true contact with the mouth instead of a contact that's braced by his neck, which means you could have more contact than you want. So you lose the feel if you go over his neck. But don't worry about it right now. And he's relaxing even better. He's already gained 2 inches in his neck. Good boy. Gets them to the point where they're stretching, and sometimes it takes 45 minutes. How long do you have a long line?
I don't do long line.
Because you just don't? Or?
Because I've seen too many horses inverting or falling in, falling out. Okay. I do free round time.
That's fine once they know how to stretch, but when you're teaching the stretch, it's really hard. So, do we have a lunge line?
I have one.
Let's just, because I think, we'll try the other side. I just want to see what you've got. So,
let me just
switch sides. So, this inside line is going to be attached to the outside. The outside ring comes forward here. You want to turn, you kind of use the outside rein more, and then just keep his head where you want. Good. You've got a fantastic walk. I'm not sure why he's holding his tail to the left. That's a little concern. Is that normal for him?
I have never done that. I'm riding him, so unfortunately I don't see the tail.
Yeah, right.
I think the woman just showed up.
He Yeah, keep an eye on that. We should film it so you can see it. If you, hi Abigail.
I got your call and then I called back, but I was driving and it didn't.
And I turned my phone off.
And you turned it off.
I was just worried that.
Yeah, and I went by and I passed you.
Yeah.
So, what's that?
Of course I did.
Of course you did. And then I didn't turn it off.
Right, right. Welcome.
Thank you so much.
One or two?
Just one more.
Okay, perfect. And he was fine?
Yes.
Getting on by himself? Fantastic. I'm gonna need a lunch.
Normally the whip is like this for writing. Now I have to put my hands the other way. And put the rein here so I can control the whip, not this way.
So it actually goes down from your hand?
Like this?
Yeah, so it mimics the whip and, or your leg.
Okay, so it's going right here.
Yeah, but you really want your hand as far up here as you can get it.
Alright.
Yeah, yeah. And then.
And this one here.
Closer if you really want, if he's not listening.
Okay.
If he comes into you, you lift up on the inside and then, once he steps away, you relax it.
Okay.
So you're trying to reward him every time he does something you like, which is usually don't interfere. Walk with him, give him some rein, not all of it, but enough that it's just the weight of the rein. And then follow him, you're walking beautifully, so. And let's do it on the other side so you can see it.
Okay, so I come.
We're gonna flip to the other side.
This is gonna come.
Oh boy.
Like that, I turn it this way, I put my rein in here.
Yeah. And then you can use those other three fingers or two fingers to activate it. And your thumb sort of is relaxed so it can fall downward. Watch your foot.
Yeah, I see.
That was close. I have a blue one too, Krista.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, you haven't seen that. You like it though, huh?
So is yours longer or?
No, it's exactly the same whip.
Oh, okay.
In fact.
Now.
What's the name again?
Winston.
Oh yeah. Out. I know. Horses. That's what it's all about, horses. So with this, I'm just mimicking what we did. Unfortunately, without side reins, I don't have an outside rein.
Right.
But he's just going to pay attention to the horse, you know. Out. And I'm just asking him to step under. I don't care what else he does. I don't care what he does with his head. I want him to walk around me. Be relaxed. Number one is relaxation. If you don't have relaxation, you've got to back up to where you do. And that may mean, like right now he's not relaxed, so what's the point? I mean, the work will make him relax once he knows what to do. Mm-hmm. But he's not sure what to do. So, good boy. So if you run into something where he's just not paying attention, you need to, even if it's just getting him on the lead and walking him down the lane. Good. So in the left hand looped line, then you break it with the whip hand, and that's what's talking to his mouth. And the whip is your leg. So, he's doing great. Now see how he's relaxing his head? He was. If they have to poop or scratch, just stop.
I do that.
There's no point. You're not at a horse show. I'm going to be at a horse show. Once you're at a horse show, then you grab your thing over there. There. Good boy. Good boy. See, he doesn't know what he just did.
I know.
But I'm going to make a big deal of it because he just put his nose on the sand. So he knows that's something he can do. And maybe he'll do it without, you know, on cue. So I taught my horse a little stretch.
He said, okay, the cue would be head down. He does it with the poker on and he's
oh, perfect.
Tight. And so
there you go.
Head come down. Means.
I'll use it. Good. Head down. Head down. Out. You tell him out better?
Yes.
Out. Good. Head down. Head down. So I'm using a little tension here on the inside rein to ask him to come into me. Down. Head down. Head down. Nope, 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 nope. Now, if he had side reins on, he couldn't turn in too much.
Right, I see.
He has a little bit of a wiggle worm.
He controls the bend.
Head down. So I'm asking when his inside hind is in the air. You can't do anything unless it's in the air. Good boy. Head down. Out, 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 out. Good. He doesn't have any trouble with forward. So I'd keep the whip behind you and use this to tell him how far to be away. And see how I'm just graduating from the in-hand work? So he's a little further away, just like a lead dog. When you're teaching him to come. Get further and further away. As long as he's relaxed. Stepping under with the inside. You can tell if they're, you really want the hindquarters slightly out of the circle.
Okay.
So what I do is I watch where his right hind lands next to the right front.
Correct.
And if it's an inch on the outside, that's enough. Especially with a gated horse, they're pretty stiff over the back.
So you're looking at the inside leg trying to fall farther?
No. No, on the circle, I can tell if he's got haunches out by watching the footfall, the mark in the sand, of this right hind, where it falls, it should fall right here.
Okay.
On the outside.
So it's the same size. The same size.
Same side. Exactly. You're all tight up here. There you go. Come on, walk. Walk on. So he's perfectly safe to lunge in the lunging arena. And this is really the best way for him to learn to use himself at a faster gait. I mean, you're not going to trot him. Does he trot?
No, he's not supposed to. I mean, he wants to uphill, but I say no.
Well, for now,
yeah.
You want him to trot.
Because he gives up the...
While you're teaching and while you're building the top line, don't worry about any of that, because that is what builds the top line. Gating does not, because he has to stiffen his spine to gait. You want his spine to be able to do this and be a wave, because that's using all those muscles.
I have lunged him, a free lunge in the circle, and if he trots, then it's fine with me, because I have no problem.
Yeah, you're not riding him.
It's only when it's riding that I don't want to
Now, so you might, you know, if you're willing to really put him on the right foot, use this year to build his back, and don't gate. I would not gate for a year. But that's up to you.
Not what?
Not gate. No gating.
Oh, no gate. Oh.
Until he gets a top line. It takes a year. And it's every step. You're the building top line or you're not. You might even be breaking it down. So until you actually build the top one, and I think he'll build it fast because he's got a good walk, there has to be a certain amount of activity to activate those muscles. So if you have a horse that's slow, you got to get him to walk like this, marching, marching, going somewhere. I'm going to get to the next town. Matt and I'm wandering around, going not in the same direction.
Good boy.
Good boy. So I'm letting him out a little further, see what he does. Head down. Head down. He's just a little tense today. That's okay. It doesn't happen in one day. But the first time he puts his head down, I would quit with it. Especially today, because he's being so good. And it seems like he's not doing anything. This is a lot of work for a young horse, for their mind especially. Good. Left hand. Relax. See, I turned the whip around, and he said, oh my God, we're going somewhere. Come on. Because I'm further away, I need a longer line. You have to be able to touch him at some point. Walk on. He's like, you can't get me to do anything over there. I'm like, yeah, watch me. Good boy. Let's go. I'm going to walk with you. No, not faster. Yeah, we want him to feel like you should be telling him when to walk and gait.
Yeah.
You should be able to do all three gates, four gates, on command, not just because you told him no.
No.
Walk on. So he needs me to be a little closer. Walk on. He's really reached his mental limit.
Yeah, I think so.
And I just want to see if he'll relax this way and never quit. Never quit when they're upset.
Right.
You try something different.
Yeah, to be successful.
Oh, that was a big breath. Come on. Come on, walk. I want to end on a very positive note. Even if I have to go back to the other side,
sure.
He knows I'm not paying attention to him because I'm talking. So I'm going to shut up for a minute.
Mm-hmm.
Are you talking to me?
Nostrils are going?
Yes.
He's working. Now he's going in this small circle. And he's good boy. Head down. down. So the first time it goes all the way to the ground, it's going to stop. So that's okay, they're going to reward it. But after you've done it once, you have to be quick with your reactions and say, don't look up. Don't stop. Because when they drop their head, an endorphin is released. Start him on this side and reward him for the stretch. That was good. I'm doing it more than just clip those reins back on. And good boy. So you can start that when you're starting the in-hand work.
I feel very good about using the round thing because now I know what to do.
And if you really want him to complete the cycle, he needs to learn where the bit contact is. Because our hands usually are not educated. Every horse is different. Some horses need more contact than others. And you don't want to just throw it away. And it's like, I pretty much take a contact with my horse every stride. It's not a seesaw. It's a give and hold, a give and hold. And that is what will train your hands. So everything is incremental. You start on the ground. If you can't work and hand your horse correctly, you can't ride correctly. There's no way you can know what that horse wants. You can't force it from the ground. They'll just stop and go, put their ass in front of them, put them behind them, and then you've got to start over. So you can't force them into a contact from the ground. If you whip them, they throw their head up, you're going nowhere. So it's a great way for the rider to learn what is correct, because they will give you the stretch on the contact. Keep doing it for as long as you want. It takes a long time. They have to be able to hold the stretch, they have to build these muscles long enough that they can hold it.
Yeah. Now, on Keith's defense, I have to say, when we trail ride, we don't gait all the time.
Yeah.
And he has, when he walks, his head is normally down.
Oh,
and so even if sometimes he's literally almost touching the ground,
that's perfect.
And so I let that happen because I know that stretches
them. Yes, and that's why this looks good.
Okay. Right.
Yeah, but the more you can do that this year, and while he's still growing, you keep that. It'll create the growth in the direction you want it to be, rather than having them full grown and now you got to retrain the entire musculoskeletal system.
Right. Okay.
Well, do you want to take him out with this, or you have
Your
own?
Thank you, Crystal.
And that's the size it'll go. Oh, you can?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, let's go up a hole. That'll help us.
This is a I grab everything. I said there were old stuff. Is it of Winston?
Very hyper.
Exactly. Oh. When I first got her, she could not walk. The only thing she knew was how to rock as fast as she could when we inverted.
Baby, she looks great from your work already.
Thank you.
Her back has come up, huh?
Yes. Yeah, and she built. She was very skinny.
So
this is an injury.
That came.
It came with it.
And she fell or something?
A big guy was riding a Western saddle. And so when I got her, my only concern was, what is this going to be to her health?
Right.
The vet says the worry is that tissue.
It's all scar.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So now she was the one that when I called you, I was really upset because she was hurting.
Mm-hmm.
She had she was starting to develop a rain rot on the inside.
Oh, that'll do it.
And so I did
very
not know because at the beginning
right?
it was, I couldn't touch her. I couldn't even do
oh.
this. And I noticed the after I talked to you the next day, I said, you know, because I brushed them every day. I saw this one.
Yeah.
I thought this is the beginning. So I treated her and. She has responded to the training for, like, she is able to do a size pass. No, I'm not saying it's perfect, but what I'm saying is she's so responsive that
yeah, yeah, she's trying so
she,
hard.
Yes.
So it's all about relaxation.
Yes. So as I said, it took me a whole year to say finally, oh, I can walk.
Yeah, and they, well, I don't know if I said this to you, but they get to decide the timetable. It's not me.
Yes.
If they get upset, all right, what were you? What were we doing where you weren't upset? So she can do this, and it's really, you know, she's in a new place, new person. There, walk on.
And she's much more agile than Winston, and much more, you know, she's like a little
Ferrari.
Yes.
Yeah.
She's a sport. She's my little sport car.
Yeah.
And I don't really ride as fast as I used to when I had Morgan and you know and,
yeah.
and my Arrow.
Right.
But right now, what we do, I don't ride in groups because she gets too upset, so I
right.
give that up. And the only thing we do is riding alone or two, maximum three people.
Yeah.
And she is she decides the speed. Meaning, what I'm saying is, I want her head down. I want her relaxed.
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna let you do this then.
Okay.
But she's worried about it.
Yeah,
yeah. So I'm not even using the weapon, I'm just
right.
holding it there.
Yes.
You can hold it normal.
And
because you're not
like
using
this.
It.
Chair back?
No, no. I'm fine. She just listens to whatever else tells her to do. A perfect match. You two are.
Yeah.
Yeah. So she's one of those who don't ever look at her.
Correct.
Too much pressure.
Yeah.
Just kind of soft boys.
Mm-hmm.
We're just walking here, you know,
because
she's overdoing it.
Mm.
You want this? You want that? You want? What do you want?
Mm.
And so athletic that she's giving you five things in five strides.
Yeah.
So she's got to be completely relaxed to learn anything.
Mm-hmm.
So it's highly unlikely.
It's a nice environment here.
She might actually like the lunch line because
mm-hmm.
I'm a little further from her. There's less pressure.
Mm-hmm.
Just wave the end of the rope at her.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of thing. Good girl. Yeah, you got it, Morales. It's going to be so easy once they're at home in their normal environment, and you do it, you know, three times a week or every time you work them for 5 minutes each way.
Yep.
They're going to both pick it up. But, you know how to reward when they stretch.
Well, it was amazing once she realized after the whole year that walk being head down, she herself sometimes carry herself like that. She will put her head totally down, and I give her all the rein she wants.
Right. Does she curl back, or does she put her nose forward? Do you know?
I never pay attention
to that. Yeah. Yeah, that's an important just minor distinction, because if they curl back, they've disconnected from the energy.
Okay.
So they're actually evading.
Okay.
And they won't use the muscles you want them to. Okay. So, maybe at next time, if we get together again, I will have you, do the groundwork, ride her, trying to ask her to stretch, and then I can watch you and say, do this, do that. No, she's not. She's curling.
Yep.
Now she's, so what happens when they're correctly connected and their nose is forward is they'll start to do this.
Yeah.
And that's actually the beginning of the wave, where they're asking for the bit, they're searching for the bit. So if, once they're down there, you reward by doing nothing for like one stride. And then you got to hold them down there. So you kind of say on the outside rein, good, yeah, stay there. If they start to change anything, just a little. So with them, because of the weight of them, anything they start to do, it's like an energy going in that direction. So if you can catch it before it actually becomes more than a thought, then it's easy, because they stay in the frame. If they've already done this, you've got to start all over. So that's what happens, is you don't catch it when it's down there, catch the energy, keep it there. And then at some point when they get strong enough, they stay down there and they only will bring it up when they get tired.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're tired.
Mm-hmm.
But you'll read that really well. I would like to lunge this to see, because I think that'll be less stressful.
Can you try the other side also for me?
Sure.
I've been practicing my
whip. Holding. This is frozen. These crystals. I don't even think I need the whip.
Oh.
Not today.
Oh. So she's probably stiff around the right, too.
You silly girl. You dying for that color?
Yeah.
Oh, my
pretty.
God.
Mm-hmm.
So you should,
yeah.
Where did you turn around?
What's that?
Where did you turn around?
There's a place down here. A guy was standing in the door.
Thank God. See, pulling him back out on the road?
He was a truck driver, and he did it for me.
Fantastic.
Yeah, I know. Now I know where you guys are.
The universe is watching out for Abigail today, obviously.
Yeah.
There's nothing worse than trying to turn around up here. It's not like there's a Walmart parking lot,
Wider, I can't see around here.
And you came over and looked at the place, Jen said.
I'm going to try without the whip.
Okay.
On this side.
You can just use your energy with her.
Yes, that's what I'm doing.
Yep. The only thing the whip helps with is if she's not stepping over, then you can bring it back further on her body, but she's fine. She's feeding off your body language completely. If they were all this easy. I just have to think sideways. Oh, yes, sideways. Little body language for me.
Before I started doing this part, I had
Straight is probably harder for him.
I'm going the wrong way, sorry.
There you go.
What was wrong with it?
So the closer to her wither you can get, and so you're at her shoulder, the better, but you may not be able to hold her there because you don't. You'll have to use the outside rein, Morel,
to hold her
Hold her straight, otherwise she'll curve into you.
You want to try walking her straight first.
Okay.
But she's got to learn that skill too. Mm. And bring your hand down and back. Down and back. There. You don't go up her neck unless she goes down with her head. Because otherwise you'll teach her to curl in, and she's not bending in her body, she's just bending in her neck. It really doesn't matter what she does with her neck. It's more what she's doing with her back. That's better. Starting to relax.
I remember Will saying that. Little baby tape.
So bring your arm back again and down. Yeah. More right on her withers. Yeah, so you're at her shoulder. Because if you get in front of her, she'll stop.
Yes.
So she's so body language oriented, like yes. Most mares. Stallions are too, but they're or geldings. But they're more like I'm gonna manipulate the body language. I'm not gonna respond to it. So a little shorter on your inside rein, just so that you're not completely loose, so you can activate it if you need to. To put, you know, have her go
this
away.
This is to get her head away. That's what I do remember.
Right, the shoulder and the head go away when you lift up. That's lovely. Very relaxed. So I'm going to let you lunge her because she will just get tense with me, which is counterproductive to the nice.
Yeah, she's looking, yeah. Now she's getting
good girl. Because I think once they're on the lunge lang, they kind of think, oh, I'm not that close. I can put my head down and check out the ground, and then you're there. And just walk with her, like mimicking what you just did. And if she comes in too close, then lift the line. And you want to still be by her shoulder. So that you're activating that inside hind to step away from you and sort of a little mini leg yield with the hind end. Because if you're too far forward, she thinks you're leading her, which is not what you're doing. I would actually put the line behind you. She'll see it.
If you have a hand in.
Maybe, yeah. But walk the same way, if you can, just so that you're activating her hind end away from you with that rope. And your hand can work too. That's good. A little more contact with the inside rein. Good. Now see if you can get a little further from her. Let her walk freely. More like a lunging position, but keep her moving. Ask her to go out. And around you like lunging. You know what I mean?
Want more rounded, you said?
Yeah, I want you to get on a circle where she's getting further and further away from you and still maintaining the activity and the circle herself. Instead of leading her, she's lunging now, right?
Yeah, I forgot that.
So you're stepping from work in hand to lunging position, right? And then if you walk with her instead of behind her, she'll go forward and out. Better. Yes. Push her out. Point at her shoulder. Or whatever you do to ask her to go out. But not faster.
Neck and face or neck and
So Catherine, do you want a larger circle right now?
Yeah.
Well, a little bit. I'm mainly concerned about her curving too much in her neck. I really want her to go out and take contact with the line. And she may not because she's so used to not taking contact. So this is where, you know, it's hard without a whip to get her to go out if she's not responding because she doesn't know what you want.
Okay,
so
they're
going to
try this.
Yeah. So even just the short whip like this one, you can put it behind you,
I will say,
so that you're just like this, asking her to go out, and you can point this at her shoulder.
I'm going to try the shorter one.
Because the long one also I...
You're pretty close to her right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, and I haven't used the long one, so
okay.
It will be something I need to practice.
We're just wanting her to get like onto a lunging circle, not spinning around you. So she's got to get ahead of you. You have to be centered between her hip and her shoulder. Good. And asking her to go out enough to take contact with the line. Not a lot, just enough so that you can actually influence her. And not too fast. That's a perfect walk. But she's not out with her hips. Not that I, you know, think you're going to get there today, but that's what you're looking for as you train her at home.
Okay, I will take the longer whip.
Okay.
Now I see why I need it.
Yeah.
I don't know how I'm going to use this one, but we'll try.
Yeah. Well, she's got it. You're gradually asking, and she's calm, so it's just different than what you've done before with her. Good girl. Such a good baby. Oh, but that's too much force. Yeah, and I think this is her easier side too. So if you want to teach everything on the easy side.
Yeah, first.
Then transfer it to the other side. She'll get really awkward at first, but good, 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 good girl. Point at her shoulder. No, no.
Shoulder.
Out, out, yep. Good girl.
Good
girl. Out, 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 out. Good girl. She needs a lot of encouragement, just that, yeah, that's it, yeah, that's it. And almost no negative ever.
No, never.
Just so that she can stay focused and not get frazzled. So you never back up. You always walk forward. So now you're sideways, but you're still kind of backing up. So I want you to bring the energy so that she gets on a bigger circle. Try to walk her in a straight line down the row of hay, but be that far away from her. Yeah. Yeah, that's confusing. She's like, what? Good, that's it. That's what you want to feel all the time that you're lunging, that there's always forward. Good girl. But you're going to have to be very sensitive to your body position.
Yeah.
So, burp, beautiful. Exactly. But you're going to have contact with the line eventually so that she can't run away from it. She's not going to do anything wrong ever. Oh, my God. So she is a Rocky Mountain, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, you're ahead of her. That's why she's not going forward. So over and out. There we go. You got to stay behind her shoulder to get her ahead of you. So point the butt end of the whip at her, turn it around. I wouldn't put the long end at her. I would just point the butt end at her. So flip it in your hand so it's actually behind you. Yeah, yeah, and then push her out. Now you're backing up again. Try the straight line again.
You haven't tried this.
Walk on.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
So that sort of establishes where you want her.
Good girl.
When you do the straight line.
Yeah.
And then you can start, you get the energy moving
okay.
forward instead of sideways and turned. But you're not going to do anything when she's, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, we have never walk straight on a lunge, so that's also
right,
new,
right.
new for her.
Yep. Okay. And again, at home, the round pen will give you that outside rein, so
yeah.
it won't be so hard. But eventually, you want to be able to take some contact with the bit, because that's going to be your cue for her, your ask with the hand for her to, once she's going well, to drop.
Okay.
Because that's really activating that bit to create the energy.
We're going to try the other side.
Okay.
See, you will never know. No, but she was a basket case.
I can see it totally. Anybody not as like subtle as you are would be just driving her out.
Yeah,
a big guy anywhere near her would drive her right off the roof.
And they did something also with her head because we finally have a deal. I can use the scissor to do the bridle, but don't come near with the
clippers.
And yet, the woman that comes in Florida clips most of her neck and, you know,
winter.
And I said, if she flinch at it, that's it.
We'll stop
there. I don't care.
Take it out. Who cares?
And each time we are able to do more of the thing. Now it's the fourth year.
Beautiful.
And if anybody I will recommend is doing the horse speak about, you know, I send you that link about how to understand how the horse is telling you and how you being relaxed and talking to the horse, it changed this horse completely.
Yeah, Archer Eye does the same thing because you're working with them
endorphin
and dose state.
And that's what I was so inclined to contact you. When I read that, it was immediate.
All the masters knew that relaxation was the first thing you had
to do. They lost it. Even in dressage, they completely lost it. Now it's...
Dressage is the worst.
Yeah, I agree.
It's getting as bad as Tennessee Walkers. They're torturing them. Completely, and they're all broken down at 10. That's a sure sign that you're doing something wrong. Take a horse that's as well bred as the horses are today and broken down at 10? No. Something's not right.
My stallion's 21 now. Still riding bareback.
So just be conscious.
I'm still leading her.
Yeah, as soon as you back up, she doesn't know what's going on. So you've got to be forward with your energy. It's all about energy with her. So you are thinking forward, and she'll get it. And then eventually you'll be thinking connection, and then she'll say, oh, I can actually take contact with the bit. Okay. Which you'll be able to do a little bit. Well, the problem is with her is she's going to rush forward if you give her enough cue to take contact, she'll just rush. So you'll have, it's a very sensitive spot. You'll just have to work with her till she knows what you want. And again, stopping the action and rewarding when she gives you what you want is the best reward ever. She had any foals yet? You want me to curve, don't you? Try it because I know exactly where to stand. And then she'll know what you want. And she's just peering off the foot and she's trying to
go. Across the street already. Hey, see you. My guy just said come over and say hi. See you. No, there they are. We were up all these hours.
I thought she might be just She's too excited.
I think once I teach her to walk instead of turn, that might be a good thing.
I'm trying this side. Usually I teach them to walk with the whip behind me like this. Ooh. Good girl. I can't even look at her, or she's gonna.
My black brains are flip off brains, so could I just match them with his head or take them off?
Let's see. Okay. We'll do the in hand first and see what happens, see how long they are.
Like I said, he's more used to the lunge.
Yeah, and that might be what we end up with. I just want to transfer the work in hand to the lunge eventually. Perfect. And maybe look at your saddle before I leave. Much better. Much better. Perfect. You got the triangle going on. Up, you're backing up. Try to make your steps a little more like in the direction that she's going. That will help push her onto the circle.
So, this, where?
More like that, but not too far behind her.
Okay.
You've got to be waving her out while you're walking forward at the same time. Yeah. She needs to take up the contact on that line herself.
I want you to do a straight line.
Now walk forward. Yeah. You get ahead of her though, so you have to drive her forward before you ask her, when you start walking first.
Good girl, good girl.
Yep, I'm on the wall, Mommy.
Where are you going?
It's so much easier at home. That's why we're planning to, we're starting, well, he's already developed a World Dressage Federation that will have online competitions based on training level. So he's got all the first level tests done. And the competitions will all be virtual, so you don't have to trailer them, and they can be at home in a relaxed setting. Don't have the danger of having somebody, you know, jump out in front of you with a horse trailer. Good girl.
Good girl.
The battery's not sticking along. That's awesome. I don't think she's naturally wound up. I think they made her wound up. So breeding a horse like this, you're not going to get that. I don't think you're going to, if you get a stallion that's calm, like Winston, you're going to get a beautiful baby that, you know, you train them up correctly and all that craziness is something they put in, just like Arabs, they make them crazy.
Yep, or Morgans too.
Yep.
I had one too, actually.
Yep.
It's like a change that I couldn't
take. It's very hard once they teach them to be like that, to bring them back to this. It's always better to start from correct behavior and build on it with no holes. So the side reins might help her a lot because it gives her, it's actually a sense of security. Yeah, yeah, where she would act. And she's got to learn the contact herself. She's too sensitive and too quick. And once she's like comfortable, then you'll be able to transfer it. But
I skipped that very important step of training with two reins because I don't know how to do it.
Ah.
And so I said, instead of me doing it wrong,
right.
Let's stick to what I know.
Sure.
I know, right?
That's smart. Very smart on your part.
So I will love to.
Yeah.
To.
So next time we'll I can bring my Sir single.